My name is Lisa Eby, and I'm an aquatic ecologist at the University of Montana in the wildlife program, and a lot of what we focus on is native fish. One of the topics we're actually looking at is how life history changes, such as loss of a migratory life history strategy, changes the ability of native populations to respond and stay connected on the landscape. So a lot of the small dams that we've put on the landscape have isolated both cutthroat trout and bull trout. But if there are barriers to movement, then you're essentially keeping animals from being able to change their distribution. I got into science to do research, but after interacting with students during my PhD and postdoc, I realized I really wanted to continue to interact with students and teach.
Part of my dissertation is sort of looking at the flip side of this isolation story. So when we're restoring streams, who's benefiting? So are we benefiting our native fish? Are we increasing habitat for native fish? Or are we just increasing this connection and potential for competition or hybridization or predation from non-native fish? Electrofishing is, in my opinion, one of the most fun aspects of field work. I like to think of it as a backcountry video game because it's very fast-paced. It stuns them for just a few seconds, and we're able to net them out of the water and take a tissue sample from a fin that regenerates, and I'm able to take that back to the lab. And so there's just a whole plethora of knowledge that you can gain from this genetic work. My research allows me to really work with managers and answer their questions and help figure out what are the best strategies for protecting our native species.
A lot of our questions and topics sort of surround where are the uncertainties in management. And so that allows us to work with managers, we work with Fish, Wildlife, and Parks, we work with the Forest Service, and we work with the Confederated Salish and Kootenai tribes a fair amount. Again, trying to understand how their management actions or potential conservation strategies may play out in the long term for conservation of cutthroat. Even though the wildlife biology program is highly ranked across the nation, I think one of the things that makes students want to come here is the fact that it's in Montana and you can do research right out your back door. And from an undergraduate perspective, that makes it really nice because we can incorporate this right into our classes and into our teaching. We do a lot of field-based labs and projects. They're great systems to work in, and they're just teeming with life, which a lot of people don't realize. There's a lot to appreciate about just sort of the way aquatic systems work and what they do for us.